bittersweet memories. That is all.
Ladies and gentlemen, celebrate with a round of applause. Keep clapping for them. It's their day, they're the reason why we are here. If you're happy to be here, a round of applause for them.
Thank you for how it started yesterday, and everything went well. And this evening, we'll even be more blessed than that of yesterday in Jesus' name. You said in everything we should give thanks to you, because you are the one who was, who is now, and who will forever be. We praise and honor and adore your holy name. May you kindly accept our thanks and praises in Jesus' name.
Amen.
As we are celebrating the corpus, we pray that you will bless them once more. You will guide them. You will protect them. You will give them joy. And you will let their blessed be their marriage be specially blessed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All their parents will be blessed as well, and everyone that comes here will also be blessed.
Amen.
And the joy we are celebrating now, all of us who are married will be blessed. Those who are yet to be married will celebrate their own like this in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you for hearing our prayer. For our prayer in the mighty name of our Lord, Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
I am not shy and overwhelmed. It's an understatement. But just as the company has said, I've been mandated to come and say some few things. And that is why I am here on behalf of Jennifer and Felicia. I'm so excited and happy to be here. And I see myself on the team to stand before these very distinguished audience to say some few things. Let me tell this very distinguished audience, the very first time Felicia brought Jennifer to the house, I went behind Jennifer and I did something like this to Felicia. Is this the person? I didn't say what, well, when I was pointing, is this the person? It was like constant contact. When they left, I told my wife, I said, don't mind me. He's no longer in the market. Because this lady I'm looking at, she's very cultured. The way she interacted with me and my wife that day, I just knew this lady is very cultured. That this position that I know, he's already caught, he's no longer in the market. So I'm so glad that my prophecy has come to pass. I'm sure my wife will start respecting my prophecy from now on. For you, sure, if anybody tells you that Jennifer is not in trouble, forget it. It is natural for women, don't say I told you, to be troublesome. Don't say I told you. Even my mother, my sisters, all of them, it is natural. My wife, I didn't say that. Somebody here mentioned my wife. I didn't say that. Jennifer, if anyone tells you that pollution may not be naughty, forget it. I'll be practical. All the statesmen who are here, don't say I told you. Our mothers will need the best judge to be able to say it. But there are three golden rules. There are three golden rules. Rule number one. Don't stop dating because you're married. Continue to date each other. Let everybody be like that. That very first day that we met yourself. The issues will be there. But if you continue to date, you continue to be romantic, it will go naturally. That is rule number one. Rule number two. When the issues come to the fore, endeavor to discuss the issues and resolve them. And don't look for the winner. It is not a chess game. Don't look for the winner. Rule number three. When the tempers rise, watch your tongue. When the tempers rise, watch your tongue and watch your anger. Believe me sincerely, I'm not learning the ropes. If anybody tells you I have it in rocket science, how it works, don't mind them. You will walk your own road and you will define your own ways and your own strategies to make it work. One thing I am confident of, and which all the statesmen here and all the men of goodwill and women of goodwill here will be confident of, is that you will make this a success. Your children will surround your table and you will see your children's children. That is our prayer for you. Felicia, Jennifer, this is just the beginning of your very best.
Paris and everyone who looks at me tonight, I'm going to be very brief because I'm going to hold my stomach in for about 2 minutes. So. But I just want to first of all congratulate Felicia and Jennifer. I'm so happy to be with you. And I'll just talk a little bit about how I met Jennifer and how I know her. So I met Jennifer a few years ago at a house party, a Christian house party. And we did the baby to each other, and then a year later we met wedding and we hit it off immediately. And literally about 3 days after we met, Jennifer was going back to Nigeria and I was staying in London and we cried because we were needing each other. And she convinced me to move to Nigeria, and ever since I moved here she's been so supportive, she's been so loving. And when I started my business, Jennifer was literally there handing out leaflets on the street with me, Jennifer, at Domino's. It didn't work, but it was worth a try. So Jennifer, Charlene, and Felicia, I wish you all the best. I love you so much. Thank you for being such a wonderful friend. Felicia, thank you for being so wonderful to Jennifer and for taking her away from us. And I wish you guys nothing but the best.
A bridesmaid, I said yes, and then she said the wedding would be in Nigeria, and I said, oh. You know, for a lot of us, I grew up in the States, spent most of my life in the States, even though I am Nigerian, it's hard to come back, and I was really nervous. You know, I had been back as a child, and didn't have the best experience, but I know. And his amazing family, Jennifer's family. But I have to say, blown away by the warmth, the kindness, and the beauty of this country and the people, my people. You know, I feel as an American and a Nigerian living. good representative of our country and our people, and I feel like from this experience, I'm even more so. So thank all of you for being here, for looking so amazing and so wonderful. But most of all, thank you to these two, Mr. and Mrs. Nigeria, I think so. Can we get a round of applause for these two? And I hope everyone has a wonderful evening. Thank you.
You're welcome. Thank you. Well, today I'll not show myself. So I'll start by saying a few words about the couple. Felicia, my dear brother. Number one entrepreneur. I remember about 10 years ago, I just got into university or thereabout. No, I was like in my second year. And then Felicia, it was more than 10 years ago. That's how maybe I think we were 100 level, Felicia was in 300 level. And I just remember Felicia said he wanted to start doing business. I said, which business? Brother, we're still in university, let's enjoy our youthful time. He said, Felicia saved up all his pocket money and bought a motorcycle. He went to go and look for one rider, put that motorcycle in front of Lekki Gate. Painted it white, that time was only white on Canada. And that's how they were giving him his money every week, like 5,000. That time 5,000 was big money in my eye. I said, before we knew it, while I was still following his footsteps, he left Okada alone, he went to go and buy Okada Lekki, he said no problem. He entered diesel business. I said, which one is diesel? He went to buy, we need to buy steel. Mom, I'm sorry. Remember that your Mercedes boss, that time? Felicia used to steal that boss. Load the back of that bus with diesel and do home deliveries one after the other. And I was like, gosh. And ever since then, he's been moving like that in leaps and bounds. Felicia, we envy you in your entrepreneurial skills. We're still following you behind. We're proud of you. Congratulations for bringing Jennifer home to us. I remember when I met Jennifer. I actually met Jennifer before Felicia coincidentally in London. I never ever knew that how many years later Jennifer was still coming to our household. So this wall nobody can see tomorrow. Welcome Jennifer. I'm happy to have you in our household. Hurra. Well done for bringing Jennifer home to us. I appreciate you. Felicia and Jennifer, congratulations. I wish you the very best. You may be older than me, but I can teach you one or two things about marriage and stuff. All I can say is that just be patient, that's all. Can you come back?
Again, my name is Jimmy, I'm a Felicia's older brother. The quiet one. So I thank you very, very, very much for honoring us this night. I can't believe that we're here celebrating Felicia's marriage. He's the last one. There's only one left, so I'm happy to give his hand out today. I promised myself I would not grow into it. Felicia has grown increasingly patient, increasingly kind, increasingly generous, and increasingly wise. Me and Felicia are close, and we're very close when he gets into trouble. When I see two missed calls from Felicia, well, consider us to be funny, especially on a night out.
Second brother, my new brother from Felicia. I met Felicia about a year ago in the Brooklyn. I used to live with Jennifer. She became Jennifer's motherly instincts are so horrible. Like the one with my sister, she's my mother, because she's very strict. Then that thing being done, her workers, I probably come about like that. And she, yeah. So, moving on, my new brother Felicia, when Jennifer introduced me to you, from the mini, from the first time I met you, I knew you were one. You have such a strong hand, strong hold, you're cool, you're relaxed, you can handle this stubborn child, but she needed somebody to handle her properly. Jennifer is late here. But anyway, I love her. I'm going to love my life. I can't help it but love her. I mean, I'm going to make my lady wife.
To long life, to good health, to beautiful children, to the best that life has to offer, to 30 billion in the accounts. Dollars, 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 not there. All right, ladies and gentlemen, cheers to the bride and bridegroom. Cheers, everybody. So this is where we kick off the celebration. All our parents, please enjoy this side of the party.